Right, we're back and it looks like we're ready to go with about five. This is London Rollergirls, London Brawling versus Helsinki Rollerderby All-Star Ninja Turtles.
So first up jamming for London, we have Flaming Aggro, who's out of the pack out of turn two and picks up a lead. Jammer.
Jamming for Helsinki, we've got Tina Kimari. We saw her jamming a lot in the first bout this morning. Helsinki, of course, playing in this in the green top, green helmet, yellow stripe. London in the black.
Flaming Aggro picking up the first 4 points in this game. Had a slightly shorter halftime than we thought. Time in between the games than I thought we were going to
have. I think we're scheduled for a 6:30 start. That's Berlin time for anyone around the world, of course. And I think we pretty much hit that 6:30 start point. So everything's on schedule after five bouts.
And of course, we have Rogue Runner there.
We should say the other Rogue Runners. There's two Rogue Runners in this tournament. One for Glasgow, one for London.
And Heli Rantelli knocked to the outside by Shaolin Scarlet. Rogue Runner already completing a first scoring pass. 5 points, grand slam.
You may remember Rogue Runner for the World Cup. She actually played for the Dolly Rocket Rollers when she played for Team England and then made the move to London shortly after that. Very wise move indeed it was, I believe.
They've now moved to a power jam in favour of London. Heli Rantelli has gone to the penalty box. Didn't quite see what penalty she went for. But that's giving Rogue Runner an optimum chance to start racking up more points in this power jam situation. Knocked to the outside of turn three. Now we're just with the team captain. Dukes around the outside. 5 points. Grand slam to London.
London off to a flying start now, 19 zip already, 1 minute into this second jam.
Rogue Runner breaks through out of turn one, another 5 points, another grand slam on the board. And Heli Rantelli waiting to come out of that penalty box. Back out on track now. And coming up to the back of Raw Heidi and Grievous Bodily Charm, trying to fight their way through the middle there. Frightening Bolt recycling to the front.
Rogue Runner just knocked to the inside, forced to drop to the back of the pack now. So Rogue Runner trying to fight it through, just touches those hips and calls it off.
So London already claiming some dominance in this game. Of course, Helsinki qualified for this game, beating Crime City in the first game of the day.
Yeah, of course, London automatically went through to round two of our tournament here with a bye, same as Bear City, who you're going to see up next.
Kamikaze breaking through, picks up lead jammer, and coming around to start a scoring pass.
Yeah, we've got Cisse jamming for Helsinki. First time we've seen her today because she was not playing in the first bout this morning.
Kamikaze picking up a grand slam. And Cisse still stuck in the pack, still hasn't completed her initial pass through the pack. Kamikaze coming around for another scoring pass. Cisse goes down on the inside of the track. Kamikaze breaking her way through. Vice captain for Helsinki trying to hold her off. But Kami fought her way through.
Kami using some acrobatics there to stay upright and skating as she was hit on the way out on the pack there. Already backgrounded into the pack and through again.
Stephanie Maney recycling Cisse all the way back round to the start of turn two, and it looks like she's going to do it again.
London doing an excellent job of just bridging backwards there, getting as much of that 30, 40 feet as they can. Still forcing the cut as well, it looks like. Oh, it was dropped off from Maelstrom, our outside pack ref, showing a cut to the jam ref on the inside.
Kamikaze Kitten crashing into the back of the Helsinki wall there, picking her points very, very carefully, getting through 5 points, grand slam. And this pack really is moving slowly around the track.
Yeah, Stephanie Maney doing a great job there of just knocking Sissy to the outside and then running back again, letting Cammy just run through and pick up those points unheeded.
So just over 5 minutes into this game, the score's standing 57-0. We have Flaming Aggro jamming for London and Tina out there for Helsinki. Tina trying to get through, but London's wall's at the back of that pack, causing her a lot of difficulty. Flaming Aggro now round to start a first scoring pass. Trying to spy her way through the Helsinki wall, knocked to the outside. Gets through, 5 points, grand slam.
Yeah, Shaolin Scarlet Foxake and Frightening Bull just doing an excellent job of sitting on Tina Kamari there, just holding her in the pack, knocking her out, and then all three force it and run back behind them to stop that cut track major that she'll pick up if she steps on track. However, it looks like we're going to have a Helsinki power jam as Flame and Aggro is going to the bin now for a back block major. It's a chance for Helsinki to get some points on the board. If only Tina Kamari can get through the pack.
So Tina finally breaking the pack now and on her first scoring pass. So hopefully we're going to see some points on the board for Helsinki. Tina making her way through the pack. Shaolin Scarlet was holding off Lady Lala from going back.
Frightening Bull just going chest to chest with Tina. We're going to see the first points on the board now for Helsinki as a 5 point grand slam has dropped off.
So for the first time, Helsinki starting with an advantage, starting on a power jam. One blocker down, 4-3 in that pack. Heli Rutelli stepping up to the jam line.
Very strong London wall there, just trying to hold Heli Rutelli, pushes her to the inside. Helsinki just holding that back, just making London stretch out, pushing into the limits of that engagement zone until out of play is called. Yes, we're going to see that is the Dalai Hama going to the bin for an out of play block on Heli Rutelli.
Stephanie Maney holding Heli Rutelli off there. And now she's through again for another grand slam. Flaming Aggro out of the penalty box. Side serves around Nina Hughes. Heli Rutelli knocked to the inside. Stephanie Maney picking up a low block major on Heli Rutelli. Flaming Aggro at the back of the pack now on her first scoring pass.
Heli Rutelli breaks the pack and then vigorously calls off the jam. Helsinki bringing back some quality points there against the London Roller Girls.
Number 22, Rogue Runner, on the jam line for London. Number 23, Cisse for Helsinki. Helsinki with a blocker advantage, 3-2, currently on track. Cisse trying to find a way through. Rogue Runner hopping and stepping all over. Picks up lead, Jammer into turn one.
Cisse once again just fighting to try and get past those last two London blockers. The no pack is calling. She is released out onto track, but Roadrunner's already on her scoring pass now. Is through for 4 points. As Cisse comes up to the back of the pack for her first scoring pass, Roadrunner sees this, calls off the jam. Score now standing Helsinki on 14, London Roller Girls on 73.
19 minutes remaining in this first period. So Kamikaze Kitten on the jam line for London.
It's Gale Force jamming for Helsinki against Kamikaze Kitten for London. Kamikaze steps through, picks up lead jammer as Gale Force is thrown to the outside there by Ro Heidi. Looks like Ro Heidi is going to go to the bin for that block though.
Kamikaze Kitten getting through, picks up a 4-point pass. And Gale Force now on a scoring pass. Kamikaze Kitten watches a go through. 2 points picked up for Helsinki by Gale Force.
Yeah, that looks like it was one block up plus Raw Heidi sitting in the box.
I know speaking to a few of the Helsinki players after their, like in between the games, they were super excited to win their first game. I think they're even more excited that they get to play against London.
Yeah, it's one of those opportunities I think a lot of teams in Europe would like to even just compete against London. The chance to take points from London, though, is one of those things that any jammer would relish.
It's a lovely block and flaming aggro pushing it to the outside of the pack.
Tina Kamari also being thrown to the inside by Frightening Bolt, who runs back, hand in the air. Tina Kamari now stuck behind that wall. Steps through, just trying to push past that last blocker, but thrown out on turn two.
Frightening Bolt at the front of that pack, trying to hold off Tina Kamari. Tina gets out of the pack, but Flaming Aggro is on a scoring pass. At the exit of turn two. Turns around just inside to see Tina and call off that jam. Rogue Runner back on the jam line for London, up against Heli Rintelli for Helsinki. Helsinki with a current blocker advantage, 4-3. Raw Heidi in that penalty box waiting to come out. Must have less than 10 seconds because she's standing. So Rogue Runner now trying to get a way through. Helen Rutelli knocked to the outside. Rogue Runner at the front of the pack. Gets through, picks up Lee Jammer. And Heli Rutelli knocked to the inside there by number 51, Olivia.
Dalai Hama picks up a forearms major on turn three and is sent for a minute. Rogerner just steps up the outside of that start straight, picking up the 4 points.
And Heli Rutelli going to the penalty box has now given Rogerner a power jam. So London are going to want to capitalize on this, sliding around the outside with just inches around the outside of vice captain for Helsinki to pick up a grand slam pass. Raw Heidi picking up a direction of gameplay there. So she's going back to the penalty box. She's only just got out of the penalty box.
So there's a grand slam on the board for Rogue Runner. This is going to take London Brawling already to the 100-point mark, just over 15 minutes into this bout.
And Helsinki on 16 points. And there goes another grand slam by Rogue Runner. Already round again on turn four. Rogue Runner squeezes through the inside to pick up another grand slam. London bridging around the outside of turn four to force Heli Rutelli as far around as possible.
That's the mark of a good jammer, that is to find a hole in the wall where a hole in the wall doesn't exist. We should probably do a quick run through of the lineups here. I'll just quickly run through. London Brawling out on the track at this bout. We've got number 4 of Fox Sake. We've got 108, the Dalai Hama. 13 is Stephanie Maney. 1349, Katie Peril. 1984, Grievous Bodily Charm. 22, Rogue Runner. 33, Frightening Bolt. 357, Raw Heidi. 44, Knickerbocker Glory. 51, Olivia Coupe. 8008, Gorgasm. 888, Shaolin Scarlet. Number 9, Kamikaze Kitten. And 999, Flame and Aggro. Meanwhile,
Kamikaze Kitten is out there with Lee Jammer racking up points for London. It is Sumoy fighting to get through the pack, but being recycled.
London severely depleted on track now, blocker-wise, as we see Frightening Ball picking up an intentional destruction major.
Kamikaze with a lovely little sidestep, and Iris finally breaking that pack. Kamikaze Kitten looks like she's going to have a little bit of fun. Just waiting. Going for the inside line. Round the inside of Lady Lala. Lady Lala with a smile on her face knows what kind of a move that was.
Right, let's see if we can get the Helsinki lineup down now before the next jam starts. So we got 100 Florence Fightingale, 2014 Lady Lala, number 23 CC, 28 Nina Irwes, 33 Malice in Saint, 404 is Iris Suomainen, 415 is Ronja Riovaari, 604 is Sarah Mackey, 64 is Gail Force, 666 Lilu Dallas, 8000 is Heli Rontelli, 88 Deadbeat Debbie, 94 is Tina Kamari, and 96 is Linda Vijeskog. That is your Helsinki lineup, and we've got Linda Vijeskog jamming for Helsinki. She's going up against 999 Flaming Aggro for London Brawling, who has lead jammer. Flaming Aggro to side surf turn one there to step through that Helsinki wall. On the line for London Brawling against Tina Kamari for Helsinki. Rogue Runner out the pack already by turn two, picks up lead jammer.
Tina Kamari now out in front, knocked to the inside and recycled back to the entrance of turn three. Rogue Runner already round to start a scoring pass. Tina pushed down, exit of turn three. Rogue Runner hops around the inside to pick up a grand slam. Lady Lala going to the penalty box.
Yeah, Lady Lala picked a major there, clockwise blocking. Shaolin Scarlet just putting the bootay into Tina Kamari, trying to force her off at turn two.
Shaolin Scarlet forcing her outside.
Shaolin Scarlet stepped off the track there. I don't think Tina Kamari saw that she doesn't have to recycle back in behind Shaolin Scarlet because she left the track herself.
Lovely hit there on Roadrunner from
Gail Force, that was, without delivering that hit on the inside of turn one.
Roadrunner spying her way through, goes for an inside line, goes down, doesn't go out of bounds, and can get back up. Tina Kamari taking some heavy hits there from London blockers, taking off the panty and giving it to Gail Force. Grievous bodily charm, trying to force Gail Force to the outside. Gail Force now with the jammer penalty on for Helsinki, trying to fight her way through. Goes down.
Looks like, is that, yep, that's Roadrunner going to, is take. Roadrunner has got a cut track major on the exit of turn two, which means we're going to start the next jam, Helsinki Power Jam.
The thing I'm loving about Helsinki is the smiles they have on their faces playing this game.
I think that's the spirit of Derby, though. Win or lose, it's, you know, the experience, the fun. Just getting out there on track and playing some good Derby.
So Gale Force took that helmet panty, now starting this jam. Stephanie Maney knocking Gale Force to the inside and recycling her way back past the jammer line. Stephanie Maney, such a formidable blocker. Olivia Coop.
London once again stretching that engagement zone out at the front. But we have Gail Force out of the pack with lead jammer. Still probably got about 10 seconds of this power jam remaining.
The thing I love about watching London is their awareness of where they need to be and where they, the way they bridge.
Okay, Roadrunner is standing now, so we're going to have the power jam ending in less than 10 seconds now. Roadrunner back on track, coming up to the Helsinki four wall at the back of the pack. Just steps through it like it wasn't there.
And Stephanie Maney knocking Gale Force to the inside, drawing, was going to draw it all the way back from turn three to turn two. Gale Force just calls off that jam. She doesn't want any more.
So that's 4 points on the board for Gale Force in that jam.
Taking Helsinki up to 20 points. But London in the lead, 154, with just over 6 minutes remaining on the clock.
We had a very, very quick official timeout there. Normally in the official timeouts, we like to fill the air by talking about our lovely sponsors. People such as Inside Line Magazine, UK's first roller derby magazine, who are in fact here watching everything that's going on. If you obviously want to get yourself a copy, just get yourself to insidelinemagazine.co.uk. And here's a special thing. If you pick up issue number 5 of Inside Line, you'll find some articles written by none other than myself.
Shameless personal plug. But we love you for it, Sven.
I have to blow my own trumpet sometimes.
So Kamikaze Kitten racking up points for London. Siso trying to fight her way through, still hasn't completed her initial pass. Hopping and skipping, Kamikaze Kitten showing just how agile she is with another grand slam to London. Raw Heidi pushing Sisei to the outside of exit of turn three.
London have another blocker going to bin as Frightening Bold goes to join.
Oh, lovely maneuver there by Kamikaze Kitten, spinning around, taking a hit off of one of the Helsinki blockers and bouncing around on one foot. Just showing how experienced Kamikaze is with her lovely custom Rydells.
Of course, yes. Kamikaze Kitten, I believe, is in fact a spokesperson
She's a Rydell superstar.
Rydell superstar, yes.
Who happened to be one of the sponsors for today?
Indeed. In fact, there's a lovely poster on the way in the venue here of a giant kamikaze kitten displaying her Rydells.
Heavy hit there, knocked to the outside. Crowd pleased with that because they know how hard it is to knock kamikaze kitten out of bounds. So London's still on a power jam. Kamikaze kitten picking up another 4 points at the end of that jam.
And they're still going to be in the power jam in the next jam. And it's back to 4-4 on the pack as well as Frightening Bolt rejoined just before those whistles. So that looks like 999 Flame and Aggro is going to be on power jam duties for London Brawling right now.
Both teams starting with a full complement of blockers on track, 4-4. Dalai Harmer coming in to clear, try and clear a way through. Flaming Aggro gets out, picks up Lee Jammer as she exits turn two. Cisse standing in that penalty box, waiting to come back out on track, which she does, crashing into Stephanie Maney at the back of the pack, while Flaming Aggro at the front, trying to fight her way through.
That's quite a solid wall of London Brawling at the back there. Olivia Cooper and Stephanie Maney just doing a great job as we have a star pass.
London blockers really, really causing Helsinki's blockers and their jammers a lot of trouble on track.
Yeah, it's Iris Suominen who now has the jammer star for Helsinki.
The Flaming Aggro just weaving away through the pack. Another 5 points, another Grand Slam on the board.
That's going to take London over the 200-point mark now to 203.
Heavy hit there from Stephanie Maney out of turn one, forcing Iris Sumoyoy to the outside of the pack.
Once again, we've got that London Brawling swarm around Iris Sumoyoy. Stephanie Maney, I think we've seen her running backwards with Jammer trailing her on the outside, and this time successful in forcing the track cut. Just a minor, so it's only the fourth minor, but sometimes a minor will do it for you. So we're still a power jam, London Brawling Rogue Runner at the line. Helsinki one blocker down, but they do have a blocker standing at the moment.
So Rogue Runner coming up against the Helsinki three wall, but goes around the outside out of turn two, picks up that lead jammer on the power jam situation. Cisse at the back behind the London blockers. As Rogue Runner comes around for a first scoring pass, easy round the outside, 5 point grand slam. And Rogue Runner coming around again.
Big stumble there on turn three, but Rogue Runner is through with a grand slam still.
So Rogue Runner edging away through the inside, little turn round, picks up another grand slam, another 5 points on the board, taking London's score up to 233. Helsinki still sitting on 20.
The grand slams just keep on coming here as Rogue Runner is allowed to just step through the wall once more.
And Iris Sumoyoin comes out of the penalty box and sneaks through the London blockers. but Rogue Runner calls it off, preventing Helsinki from picking up any points. Seconds left in this first half. Possibly one more jam to play. Ellie Rutelli on the jam line.
Yeah, it looks like there's 7 seconds left that's allowed us to have a last jam.
It's Knickerbocker Glory on the jam line for London. Helsinki holding her off. And Heli Rutelli trying to get through. Knickerbocker Glory goes around the inside. Picks up Lee Jammer, but Heli Rutelli out hot on her heels as well. And Knickerbocker Glory going to the penalty box for a back block major. Now puts Heli Rutelli on a power jam. So a 5-point grand slam to Helsinki.
Heli Rutelli now just got to try and get past that London wall as many times as you can and rack up the points. But London are not going to make it easy, as we can see. Kamikaze Kitten and Stephanie Maney just at the front of the pack there, doing a great job of slowing her right down. We're going to have a change in power jam. Fourth minor for Heli Rutelli releases Knickerbocker Glory back on track.
She is sitting in that penalty box with a smile on her face, knowing how much she's enjoying this game.
Well, this next pass is going to take London over the 250 mark to 225 to Helsinki. Coming up to the end of period one.
There we go with that grand slam, courtesy of Knickerbocker Glory. Kamikaze Kitten trying to sweep the inside there.
Well, Heli Rutelli's coming back to track with about 13 seconds left of the period. No lead jammer, of course. Both jammers have been to the bin. So we'll go for these remaining few seconds. And it was 3 more points for Heli Rutelli. 4 dropped off for Knickerbocker Glory. So that's going to give us, at the half time, Helsinki on 28, London Rollergirls on 261.
Looking over at the Helsinki team, they're just full of smiles.
Yeah, I mean, they're through to the second round. They're playing London Brawling. What more could you want?
Okay, so we're ready to get back underway for the second period of Helsinki versus London. Both teams are going to be starting with a blocker down. And we're seeing Stephanie Maney step up to the jam line.
It's Linda Vigescog, the name that I love to pronounce because I'm sure I'm offending someone when I say it.
So Linda currently at the front. Stephanie Maney being held off by Helsinki. Helsinki trying to keep as tight a wall as possible. But as I say that, Stephanie Maney finds to the slightest hole, breaks through, and picks up a lead jammer.
Linda Vigescog just got to get past Katie Peril. And Olivia Coupe at the front of the pack here, doing so on turn two. Helsinki swarming Stephanie Maney, trying to prevent her from getting through, but she just switches to the outside and is back round for a natural grand slam.
So Katie Peril at the front, going out of play, having to let Linda through. And Stephanie Maney blasting around the inside, gets through, calls it off. Yes. So London's score going up to 270 points. Helsinki on 28. Flaming Aggro on the jam line for London. I believe that's Gale Force up there for Helsinki. Gale Force trying to fight her way through. Flaming Aggro going around the outside. Helsinki recycling, but gets through. Picks up Lee Jammer. And Gale Force being chased out the front by Rawhidey. Rawhidey determined to get her back in that pack.
Flaming Aggro out in front, but Gale Force hot on her heels as they come up to the back. Flaming Aggro tries the apex jump. However, it was misconduct there for contacting a skater feet off the ground. So Flaming Aggro managed to successfully call the jam, but is actually sent off for a misconduct. Looks like Ballistic is just going in to check that with Major Travis T now. So we're going to have a probably, I would envisage, nope, it's going to be the next jam starting. I was going to think there's going to be an official review there. So a Helsinki power jam.
It's Lilu Dallas out there trying to get away past Stephanie Maney, trying to sidestep Stephanie Maney, pushing her to the outside.
Once more, as I've said before, Stephanie Maney doing a great job of just forcing the jammer out and then running backwards. Helsinki doing a great job there, just holding that wall at the back, forcing London to stretch this out.
Lilu Dallas trying to force that three wall at the front. Helsinki's trying to swarm on Olivia Coupe at the Helsinki back of the pack.
Helsinki there, I think they're trying to force the no pack by pushing Olivia Coupe out, who was the only person holding the pack in place at the time.
Flaming Aggro out of the penalty box.
Lilu Dallas there took the minor, but it looks like it was the fourth minor. She took a minor cut. Bad mistake, as that was fourth minor for Lilu Dallas.
So an unfortunate mistake for Lilu Dallas there. Flaming Aggro now up against four Helsinki blockers. Powers through, but goes down, back up. Spinning around. 5 points and a grand slam on the board for London. So London up to 275 points. Helsinki on 28. Another grand slam to London. Vice captain for Helsinki, Nina Hughes, going to the penalty box. So Helsinki are going to be a blocker down. So Roadrunner stepping up on a power jam up against three Helsinki blockers. Frightening Bolt comes through, clears away through the center of the pack, and Roadrunner is flying off at lightning speed. Pack is on turn two. Grievous Bodily Charm going down. Roadrunner juking to the back, trying to cut to the inside. Gale Force goes on the floor. Seeing great communication from London. Lilu Dallas stays in bounds. Rawhidey knocks her down out of turn four. Roadrunner going through with another grand slam. Star pass to Gale Force. Gale Force now with the jammer panty on for Helsinki.
Gale Force seems to be the go-to pivot when it comes to the star pass for Helsinki.
Roadrunner coming around.
Got Rawhidey going to the bin on the back of turn three there. Looks like an illegal engagement on Gale Force.
Lulu Dallas picking up a low block major. She's going to go to the penalty box, and Gale Force still trying to get out of the pack. Frightening Boulder at the front, trying to hold her off, trying to shove her to the inside. Now moving to the outside, but Gale Force goes round shoulder to shoulder with Rogue Runner. So 4 points for Helsinki. Rogue Runner sneaks around the outside, and a grand slam.
Looks like I've got a timeout, Helsinki.
London have reached the 300 mark, 308 to 32. 22 minutes left on that period clock.
As usual, we'll take this time to thank one of our sponsors. And so let's go to Bont Boots. Lighter, stronger, faster. Proudly Australian since 1975. Bont was the first manufacturer to start using exotic materials such as fiberglass, Kevlar and carbon fiber, and the first to use heat-moldable resin and thermoplastic in their boot construction.
And of course, Atom Wheels, the official wheel of WFTDA and Team USA, they are radically different. So Iris Sumnoy up against Knickerbocker Glory. Knickerbocker Glory goes around the outside of turn one, picks up lead jammer. Stephanie Maney holding off Iris at the back of that pack, pushes her to the outside, now recycling her all the way back to that pivot line as Knickerbocker Glory goes through for a grand slam. And again, we're seeing a formidable blocking from Stephanie Maney.
Finally, Iris Sudomainen gets out of the pack, but Knickerbocker Glory just calls it off as she does. Okay, just a Twitter shout out for Renegade, thanking Berlin for the streaming coverage that we've got all this weekend.
While we're saying that, Flaming Aggro is out of the pack with Lee Jammer. Lady Lala stepping to the jam line, team captain for Helsinki. Flaming Aggro now on a scoring pass for London. And Lady Lala trying to fight her way through, going down. Heavy hit there.
It's a big hit from Linda Vijeskog onto Flaming Aggro, just throwing her across the infield.
Didn't quite knock her to the infield though, all the way. And Flaming Aggro now on yet another scoring pass.
Lady Lala being forced to recycle back probably a third of a track to get in without the cut track. Flaming Aggro just comes around again for another pass at this pack.
So Lady Lala yet to break the pack on her initial pass. Flaming Aggro with another grand slam. And Fox's sake was holding her off there out of turn one. Grievous Bodily Charm using Shaolin Scarlet at the front of the pack. Just trying to force her to the outside. So Lady Lala pushed outside of turn one by Shaolin Scarlet, and now being recycled way, way back past that jammer line. Flaming Aggro hops around the inside, just stays in bounds there.
Not quite got the balance there to keep herself in bounds. So, just under 20 minutes remaining of this second period. The score standing at 32 to Helsinki, 344 to London Rollergirls.
Rogue Run on the jam line goes for an outside line. Picks up lead jammer. And Cisse in the pack, jamming for Helsinki. So a grand slam going to Rogue Runner. Stephanie Maney recycling Helsinki's jammer way back.
Looks like the CCA picks up a back block minor, but that's going to be a fourth minor. So we're going to have Rogue Runner on a London power jam right now, as yet another 5-point pass is dialed in.
Helsinki holding her out of turn four, trying to keep her there, but she breaks around the outside. Another 5 points and another grand slam. Lovely bit of skating there from Rogue Runner. Jukes to the outside as she exits turn four, gets round, 5 point pass, grand slam. As Helsinki loses their fourth blocker. Stephanie Maney recycling. Can't quite see which Helsinki blocker that was. But pushed her way back. Rogue Runner pushed to the outside. Comes back in legally. Gets through, 5 points and another grand slam. So Helsinki's jammer back out on track. And 2 minutes called.
Quite a big jam there for London Brawling. Rogue Runner just been allowed to carry on lapping time after time. Every lap a 5 point lap.
Now we're seeing Grievous Bodily Charm stepping up to jam for London Brawling. Gets through, picks up Lee Jammer. And Gale Force held at the back by Raw Heidi and Frightening Bolt.
Grievous is through already on the 5 point passes.
Yes, Grievous picking up a natural grand slam with Gale Force being held tightly in that pack, but finally breaks through.
Empty penalty boxes, Florence Fightingale returns to track, so a full complement of players on track.
Seeing another new jammer for Helsinki, their vice captain Nina Hughes stepping up to the jam line, up against Flaming Aggro. Nina gets round, picks up lead jammer. Crowd is going crazy.
Flaming Aggro as well just managed to break the pack after 3/4 of a lap. So let's see what Nina Hughes can do here.
She's determined to pick up some points. Holding off on the outside, Kamikaze Kitten trying to push her, gets through, picks up a four-point pass. The crowd here is going crazy. Picks up a forearms major. So unfortunately, Nini Hughes has gone to the penalty box and put Flaming Agra out there on a power jam.
So Helsinki now reduced by one jammer and one blocker. Flaming Agra just slides past that wall backwards there. Not sure boating, just using any technique whatsoever to get past these players.
To Helsinki on 32, and we know that Nina will be happy with the fact that she managed to get a lead jammer status over Flaming Agra.
So Helsinki, another blow to them as yet another player, Florence Fightingale, goes off track now for a fourth minor. Looks like it was an out of play engagement.
And Nina Hughes back out on track now. 2 minutes called. So Nina picking up 4 points on that jam. Takes Helsinki up to 36. And London Brawling hitting the 400 mark with 412 points. 13 minutes left on the period clock. Rogue Runner flies round the outside of her own blockers. Helsinki with just one blocker on.
So once again, Helsinki reduced in numbers to two blockers on track.
So we have S-Mac out there jamming for Helsinki. And Rogue Runner skating around, racking up another Grand Slam. S-Mac trying to break the pack. Grievous picking her out of play. Thought she was being sent off for an out of play major.
So here you go, Ronja Riavari, the only blocker on track for Helsinki until she's joined by Florence Fightingale and Ida Suominen, bringing it back to three before the jam is called off.
Flaming Agra trying to hop around the inside there, but pushed over the inside line by Helsinki, but as she breaks through, picks up lead jammer.
Gale Force just been thrown out here on the turn of one and two there by Stephanie Maney. Fights away past Katie Pearl, but Kamikaze Kittens there just to block the exit from the pack.
Gale Force took a very heavy hit off of Kamikaze Kitten on turn three, but still standing. Flaming Agra pushed the inside, coming on an outside line, trying to juke past to the inside of Lady Lala. Lady Lala not quite getting the leverage to push her out of play.
Gale Force not giving up the fight against Kamikaze Kitten. Stephanie Maney's now joined, as well as Katie Peril. Finally, Gale Force manages to break the pack. Looks as though that's drained a lot of energy out of there, trying to fight past that impressive London Brawling four wall.
T 10 minutes remaining on the period clock. Helsinki on 36 points. Stephanie Maney's gone to the penalty box. So London are going to be starting a blocker down. Again, we're seeing Nina for Helsinki jamming up against Frightening Bolt. That's the first time we've seen Frightening Bolt on the jam line. Frightening Bolt breaks through, picks up a lead jammer as she entered turn three. And Nina trying to get through, knocked to the outside by Greedy with his bodily charm. Frightening Bolt round on the outside. 5 point pass, grand slam to London Brawling. Nina fighting as hard as she can.
Frightening Bolt steps through on turn three, makes it look easy for a 5 point pass.
Nina determined to get through, but Grievous Bodily Charm in the way. Stephanie Maney out of that penalty box to rejoin London Brawling on track. Helsinki one blocker down, 3-4 on track. And Nina goes down hard on the outside of turn four, but gets back up, showing lots of determination.
Looks like that was the result of a vicious Stephanie Maney block that threw her back. And once again, we see Stephanie Maney just run back to the back of the pack to force that recycling jammer. Frightening Bolt is trying to get past Ida Sue on her mind at the front, as she does. So that's another pass completed for 5 points.
Shaolin Scarlet forcing Nina all the way back onto turn four. Frightening Bolt instructed to call it off by ballistic whistle there, London Brawling's bench coach. So your favorite name, Linda Voscek, getting through, picking up lead jammer over the Dalai Lama. The Dalai Lama crashing into the pack. Ducks around the inside, breaks the pack now, picking up 4 points.
Looks like one picked up there by Linda Vajerskog as we finish that jam. So that's leaving the scores at 37 to Helsinki Rollerderby, 478 to London Brawling, with 6 minutes and 17 seconds remaining of this period and of this game.
Empty penalty box, 4-4 on track. Roadrunner lining up against Sise. Roadrunner pushed to the outside. A lovely bit of blocking by Iris Sumioi. Roadrunner's trying to get through. Gorgasm trying to clear away for Roadrunner. And Helsinki doing a really good job of holding her off there right round to turn two. But Roadrunner picks up that lead jammer status.
Cece had just been held up at the back there by Frightening Bolt and Raw Heidi, unable to get even past the back two London Brawling players.
Got past Raw Heidi for a second there, but Raw Heidi's back and recycled it in front. The ability of London to recycle once they've pushed, once a block or a jammer's got in front of them, is quite remarkable.
Yeah, it's like reflex action. The moment that jammer stops off track, you can just see all of London suddenly bridge back to make the jammer run and recycle back as far as they can. Meanwhile, in other news, Rogue Runner steps across the apex to pick up yet another 5-point pass.
Cisse picking up a cut, but where's her fourth minor? She's going to the penalty box. So Rogue Runner on a power jam now. Grand slam pass. London score currently at 298. Once she gets through this pass, they'll have reached the 500 mark.
Well, with the points that Rogan has already picked up, that will take them past 500 now. Whatever happens, because those points have been earned. So, yep, there we go. Official confirmation. That's a 5-point pass and the call-off.
So Helsinki calling for a timeout there. Just over 3 minutes left on the period clock. And Brawling have reached 500 points, 503 to 37. Stephanie Maney standing on that jam line. So London are going to be starting this on a power jam. And Cisse's picking up their fourth minor at the end of that. Stephanie Maney just looking at where she's going to make her way through the Helsinki wall. So Stephanie Maney fighting her way through up against Nina at the front, gets through, picks up Lee Jammer. The power in Stephanie Maney's stride is phenomenal. Now background to start scoring pass. Helsinki doing the best they can to hold her off. Ducking around the inside, another 5 points and another grand slam.
Olivia Cooper just standing on the outside there, trying to make a space. Stephanie Maney, though, decides to take the inside route. Picks up another 5 points.
So Cisse out of the penalty box now. While Stephanie Maney racks up more and more points.
Kamikaze Kitten just throws Cisse off at turn four, so she's going to recycle that back right the way, deep into turn three.
Stephanie Maney, 5-point grand slam. The London Wolves just seem to be reappearing in front of the Helsinki blockers and the Helsinki jammer. I think Cisse picking up a cut track minor there. Stephanie Maney around again.
On the outside of turn two, I think Cisse thought she was through, but then suddenly met two appearing London Brawling blockers. Looks like Cisse is off to the bin again for another cut track major. So less than 2 minutes left in the period. London are going to start with a power jam.
So a very, very strong jam there for Stephanie Maney. Flaming aggro on the jam line for London Brawling. Frightening Bolt coming in to try and clear a way through. Flaming Adro sidestepping around, then Jukes to the inside out of turn one, picks up lead jammer. Helsinki back with four blockers.
Agro comes up to the wall, gets taken out on turn two, but by the time she stands up, the Helsinki wall have already gone in front of her, so she can just step straight back on the track and through the wall for a 5-point pass.
Lilu Dallas at the back of the pack there, seeing what she can do on her own. Shaolin Scarlet, Raw Heidi, and Frightening Bolt holding Lilu Dallas at the back of the pack. Adelaide Harmer waiting to come out of that penalty box.
Cece is standing in the box, so she'll be coming back on the track in approximately 5 seconds. So the power jam will have ended. Cece back on track. However, not completed her initial pass because, of course, she started in the penalty box. But once again, we see a Helsinki star pass, this time to Lady Lala.
Perfectly executed there, handing it around the inside of the blockers. And the jams ended. Helsinki calling for a timeout there.
Helsinki is their last timeout to get one more jam in this game.
And it's our favourite name again on the jam line for Helsinki.
Linda Vajeskog.
Stepping up against Stephanie Maney. Both teams with four blockers on track. Empty penalty box. Helsinki team cheering for their jammer, saying, let's go, Linda. Everyone knows this is going to be the last jam in this game.
Yep, there's 2 seconds of official time left on the period clock. But of course, that's enough to get a jam started. And once a jam is started, it can only be stopped at the 2-minute mark or when a lead jammer calls it off.
Stephanie Maney trying to fight her way through the Helsinki blockers. Now out the front, a four wall in front of her. Linda Vajeskog trying to get through at the back. Stephanie Maney is through and has picked up Lee Jammer. Linda knocked to the outside by Kamikaze Kitten. Kamikaze Kitten just staying on her stoppers, just in bounds, forcing Linda to recycle behind her. Stephanie Maney held by Helsinki, but ducks around the inside, shoots past for a Grand Slam 5-point pass. Linda still stuck in the pack. Kamikaze Kitten forcing it to the outside and recycling back.
Yeah, looks like she picks up a cut track minor as well, stepping just onto track briefly, but it's enough to force the cut. In the final minute, final potential minute of this jam.
Oh, Linda going down hard there. Stephanie Maney out in front, round Iris to pick up another Grand Slam and another 5 points on the board, taking Brawling up to 572 points. And as I say that, yes, we're going to see another Grand Slam from Stephanie Maney. And Linda Vajeskog picks up another cut track minor, but it's her fourth minor. So Stephanie Maney's now on a power jam. And it is Sumoy out the front, but has to let Stephanie Maney go.
So we've only got a couple of seconds left in the jam and the period. But that was enough for Stephanie Maney to skip past and pick up the last 2 points. So our unofficial final score sits at Helsinki Roller Derby 37, London Roller Girls, London Brawling, on a massive 584 points. I have to say though, Joker, the heart and the spirit of Helsinki to carry on fighting, even for those 2 and 3 points at a time, is just, you know, inspiring. I mean, for any team to get on track with London and always fight to the finish, even to use a timeout with 2 seconds left to just play one more jam.
I mean, the thing I loved about Helsinki watching them was the smiles they had on their faces pretty much every jam, just happy to be out there playing against, you know, the best team that in Europe that we have.
Well, that's got to be decided this weekend, of course.
Currently. And this is what, again, London doing something, a very nice gesture. It's a London Bridge for Helsinki to go under. Okay, so I'm standing here with the two bench coaches. We have Suvi Hokari from Helsinki and the lovely ballistic whistle from London. Okay, so you managed to win your first game. How are you feeling coming into this game knowing you're going to be playing London Brawling?
Our goal for this tournament was to play against London, so everyone was really excited about it. All the London skaters are like our biggest inspiration to be skating, so we just took it as a really fun learning experience.
Okay, so ballistic, what sort of tactics were you going into for this game?
Oh, you know what? We kind of went out there hoping to play the level that we play against a lot of the US teams that we played against. Like at regionals, we discovered that there was a bunch of things that we wanted to tighten up about our game. And so we went out there going, all right, let's tighten it up. Let's put Helsinki on the receiving end of it, essentially. And you know what? They gave us a real test. After the first few jams, our players were coming off the track going, they are physical. Like, they are strong. Like, we were not expecting those walls to be that tight.
Okay. So the thing I loved watching Helsinki is they were smiling. All the time smiling. So what sort of things do you do to keep that morale up?
Everyone, like, I was doing lineups today, and it's never been that easy because everyone's so eager to go to the track, and everyone's really quiet and smiling and happy. It was our biggest dream to play against LRG here, so we were just enjoying the ride.
Okay, so we've got one more game coming up, which is going to see Berlin up against Ghent. What are your opinions on the game that's going to happen?
You know what? Berlin are one of the teams that we've definitely been looking at for the final for this tournament. I mean, they fall on the other side of the bracket. There's a bunch of good teams on that side. They're one of the teams that we think could get through. So I'm going to be watching it very closely. Having said that, Ghent put up a great result against Leeds, so I don't know how this is going to go. You know, I don't know whether Ghent have got the strength to play Berlin. I haven't seen them yet this weekend, so we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Very interesting.
Suvi, what's your thoughts?
Well, I have to say that Ghent was surprisingly strong today in their first bout, so really looking forward to it. I think everyone thinks that Berlin has it, but I'm not sure yet.
Okay. Well, thank you for talking to me, and I think we'll enjoy this next game, the last game of the day, and then we're back tomorrow for some more.